very dry. That's the British protectorate of Somaliland, where rain seldom falls and life in general is pretty tough. Wealth is measured in camels, the Somalis' most precious herds. Camels provide food and they provide transport. The people could scarcely get along without them. A royal visit to this country is a rare event, and it was obvious that the youngsters in particular were out to make the most of it. During his tour, the Duke of Gloucester brought a special message of greetings from the Queen to the Somali people. The Duchess, visiting a school, was entertained by a spirited performance by girl students. Ceremonial parades were naturally quite a feature of the visit. They looked very smart, too. The Duke thanked the troops on behalf of the Queen for their loyal services in war and peace. Near Hargeisa, about 100 mounted tribesmen had gathered to express their loyal greetings. They said it with a spectacular charge across the airport. A short visit to Aden completed the Duke and Duchess's tour.
Nationalism that brought freedom to the people of Uganda and Tanganyika and Sudan and Somaliland. The Africans didn't get it by sitting in. They didn't get it by waiting in. They didn't get it by singing We Shall Overcome. They got it through nationalism.
Colonel Tuke, or the Crow, was the head of the Somali Army's infamous 5th Brigade and a recent beneficiary of Siad Barre's blossoming friendship with the United States.
Investigators say 17 men were shot and buried in this mystery.
Thank you. Somaliland wuxuu ku hambalyeenayaa munaasabadda bisha barakeysan ee Ramadaan. Waxa kale oo uu ogeysiinayaa dadweynaha in uu sameeyey qiimo dhimis bisha barakeysan ee Ramadaan awgeed. Waxyaabaha qiimo dhimista
ugu qiimo badan iyo qolol jiif la dhigayo oo qalabaysan furay baa qolkaaga yimid oo fursad qiimo badan baa la qotomiyey maanteega qaybta bukaanka la jiifiyo oo si casri ah u qalabaysan baadhitaanada oo cilmiyaysan iyo dawooyin tayo sare leh haddaba ha moogaanin.